Fiscal Year 2020 Budget of Aurora Pacific Economic Zone and Freeport Authority or APECO is hereby resumed. We ask the committee secretary to acknowledge the resource person from APECO.
Good afternoon, sir. We'd like to acknowledge the presence of President Israel Madokdok of Aurora Pacific Economic Zone and Freeport Authority. Mr. Anthony Valencia, OIC for Admin and Finance Department. Mr. Leonardo Bañares, Executive Assistant, APECO. Attorney Jerwin Bonifacio, Division Manager, Admin and General Services. Lovely Esteves, Corporate Budget Specialist, and Mr. Matthew Opeña. That's all, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Comsec. Anyway, good afternoon again. Last hearing, this presentation requested the following updates and submission of documents to the following matters. Number one, APECO Master Plan, specifically on the plan to increase the income of APECO in the next coming years. Number two, case of Attorney Archie Aldaba, specifically on the submission office. CSC clearance. Number three, legal opinion on the conflict of interest regarding the leasing of APECO lands by some of the directors. Number four, visa outsourcing and processing of function of APECO, specifically the income from the source and the data on the visas granted per locator. So I'd like to ask the President Madokdok to give us an update on these queries.
Good afternoon po, Mr. Chairman. So this morning po, we submitted all the requested documents that we are supposed to submit. We have submitted actually the APECO Master Plan. It's a nine volume. And then we have submitted the clearance of Attorney Archimedes Angara Aldaba and the breakdown of business issues, as well as we have also In that letter, we have also submitted our opinion or position paper in connection with the directors of our locators as member of the board of directors of APECO, Your Honor. Thank you.
Thank you for that update, the president of APECO, Mr. Madokdok. So yung master plan is already there, no? With the
nine volume.
Thank you for that. So the committee will be reviewing that. Tapos yung sa visas granted, last time you were asked if APECO still issuing visas upon arrival. Sabi niyo po, tinigil na po, no?
Hindi po kami nakapag-issue ng
visa upon arrival. Kaya lang nasa report po kasi based on the submission to committee LBRO mode briefer that it is expected that 12 million will be generated from passport visa and application fees in 2023. So baka pwede lang maklarify po yun pa sa 2023 kasi nandun nung kalagay po.
ESRD po.
Pa-re-replying ko po yung aking finance officer.
Sige, Mr. Valencia, good morning, Mr. Chair.
The 12 million projection on the visa issuance po is for the APECO special resident visa po and not the VUA.
Hindi po yan sa visa pan-arrival.
Hindi
so,
po.
So, it's for the resident, special
resident visa po. Opo.
Okay, so ilan po yung ilan ng average, how many visa? Residence visa do we expect every year? Kahit average po.
Right now po kasi as of September, we already issued 1,421 visa po.
1,421. Okay. So how much does APECO charge for each visa?
For each visa po, actually, it varies po eh. The principal visa is 25,000 po yung mismong visa plus 5,000 peso po on the APECO card. Kasi every visa holder po has this APECO card para pong identification po nila. That's for the principal. And for the dependents po, kasi yung mga resident visa po, visa holder po natin, minsan po nagkasama rin po sila ng kanilang dependent, ayan po, i-charge po natin ng 25,000 po.
So all of these are for the locators?
For the locators.
Wala naman sa labas?
Or on tourism to kasi, sir. Yung po yung history po, kaya po kami nakakapag-issue ng visa. The same like PRA po.
So ito isang ano natin, walang visa upon arrival?
Wala po, sir.
Yung kay Tony Aldaba, meron lang ano, did you submit already the clearance, ano, yung report on the, yung CSC clearance? Kasi natanong kasi, we have some case and may mga issues po, no, kay Tony Aldaba, was it submitted?
Meron po kami sinabit itong certificate of clearance from the Bureau of Immigration.
Okay.
Kasama rin po ito, Mr. Chair, dun sa aming in-report.
Okay, kanina, thank you for that. It was just us, no? At least the committee would want to clarify. And also, yung po sa tukol doon sa, ano, yung directors, yung sa issue ng directors leasing APECO land, sa any pong, ano, any update po?
Opo, meron na po, meron na rin po rito. Doon po sa letter namin, i-read ko po yung page 2, second paragraph. On the query whether this is a conflict of interest because parcels of APECO land are leased by some of our directors, we respectfully maintain that there is no conflict over lease agreement to local and foreign investors over the GOCC Governance Act of 2011 and other existing laws. Pinaliwanag po namin dito yung mga basis namin for in connection with the Board of Directors po na also our locators in APECO. Salamat po.
Or the members for the record of the committee or the members of the board of APECO?
Ang members po namin, we have 10 po in the board, headed by a chairperson. And then we have ex officio po, the governor of the province of Aurora, the congressional representative of the district covering the site of Aurora Ecozone, the president and CEO of APECO, the mayor of the municipality of Kasiguran, province of Aurora. And then we have one representative from the domestic investor, one representative from the foreign investor, one representative from the workers working in the Aurora Ecozone, two prominent citizens of the Philippines, of whom one shall be a resident of the province of Aurora. It even includes prominent citizens and residents of the province of Aurora for a better facilitation of the APECO Ecozone according to its mandate and current actualities po.
So you have 10 board of directors sa APECO?
9 po yung Nine. Director and 1 chairperson po.
Yung sila, Director Percival, James Lee Ramirez, Adonis Rubino, are they still part of the board?
Yes po.
Well, because we have received reports that these persons have business in APECO. So they were they conducting businesses already before they were...
Yes,
so that's the reason. Kaya kasi nagkaroon ng issue na conflict.
Yes,
that some directors are may ma-conflict, they have businesses as directors. So they were already conducted as is it true? Is it correct in saying that they already had?
Opo. Kasi kaya po yung board po ng APECO is representational.
Mga may business po sila.
May business po sa loob.
Okay, just I hope you understand. We're just clarifying some issues.
Yes po.
So in the recent years, what are the properties that APECO, may mga properties ba tayo na-acquire at nag-expand tayo?
Basically po, yung parcel 1 namin na 496 hectares, mga nasa 30% lang, 30% pa lang po na-acquire namin on the 496 hectares na parcel 1.
This is additional, bali additional po yung 496 hectares. Oh, yun.
Hindi po, yun dalawa po kasi ang parcela ng Ecozone. Okay. Isa pong parcel 1 which is 496 hectares at yung parcel 2 po, yung po tinatawag na San Ildefonso Peninsula is about 12,000 plus hectares po.
So what, transferred na po yun sa APECO?
Was it hindi pa po.
Hindi pa.
Ang latest po namin dito, lahat po ng mga nabili namin properties, hanggang BIR lang po kami dahil may issue pa po kami sa LRA kaya hindi po ma-transfer yung mga titulo.
Okay. Sige lang po. At least you just clarify. No?
Opo.
Then siguro ano natin doon yung marketing, no? Meron ba tayong marketing para to sell APECO? Do we have a marketing department dedicated, no, to market?
Pero hindi pa po yan po ngayon ang dinidesisyonan ng board. Dahil yun nga pong pagkuha ng isang marketing guy, eh yun pong sweldo ng gobyerno, hindi po sapat. Ano po? But katulad po nitong coming November, we are being invited by the province of Aurora to join them in Korea, in South Korea. And this will be an opportunity for APECO to sell APECO to the South Korean investors po.
Yes, I think also in South Korea they are more aggressive, no? They decide faster compared to other investors. Opo. Even other provinces are going to South Korea for investments. So how many offices do we maintain sa APECO now? Doon din kayo nag-hold ng office ngayon?
Meron po kaming satellite office in Pasay. Pero ang main office po is in Aurora.
Aurora.
In Kasiguran.
So do you also, ano, how often do you go to ano to Aurora?
Ako po normally commission po twice a month,
twice
or
a month
as the need arises po.
Tas based on COA report extracted from your submissions, the said commission, your income for 2010 amounted to roughly 23 million lang, ano? Nung 2021. Tama po ito?
2021 po. 23
million po. 23 million. So, medyo maliit pa, no? Medyo kulang pa yung pag-develop natin ng business talaga. As you mentioned, yung infrastructure ang challenge.
Kulang po kasi may ng infrastructure, kuryente po, tsaka po telecommunication.
So, do you have, may mga receivables pa naman tayo? Or wala naman?
Wala naman po tayong receivables.
So, wala tayong receivables?
Opo.
Okay. We're almost done. We're just clarifying para time before we approve the committee report. So yun na po, so what will be the challenges pa rin yung to market? Yung pa rin yung infra, but hindi natin nagawa ng paraan po.
Po by Aurelco, yan po yung local distributor ng kuryente sa Aurora. Ang sabi po nila, by second quarter of 2023, magkakaroon na raw po ng, makakapit na po sa grid ang eco zone. So we are expecting that ito pong mga na, nag-sign sa amin ng lease contract will continue their construction of their facilities inside APECO po.
Well, those are the issues that I wanted to that the committee wants to air. We just want to clarify. Ang ano lang talaga natin dito lang, talagang challenging bottom line. In the years of existence, talagang hindi as expected, no, yung projected income. So hopefully with the committee with the submission of the master plan, we will review. Hopefully we can improve kasi medyo ilang taon na rin to, no? Sayang hindi pa natin na ma-maximize. So anyway, we will submit this to the mother committee. Ano lang naman to, subcommittee, no? But we will submit this to the mother finance committee. Comsec, all the submitted na yung mandarin request natin. Okay. Well, as much as we want, no, yung ating potential ng APECO, hopefully we can maximize in the future, di ba? Sayang kasi ilang years na of existence. Sayang. So I'd like to thank you for your submissions. That's for the issues that were asked by the committee. But bottom line, I think the APECO has not really reached its potential, no, because of the challenges, no. Well, tignan natin. We'll see if there will be a need for the new administration, no, to look into this, no, kung but we will just submit all of this documents that you submitted also today to the Mother Committee for review as well. Okay.
Salamat po, Mr. Chair.
Okay, since there are no more questions from the other committee members, anyway, we just this is a continuation, the budget of the Aurora Pacific Economic Zone and Freeport Authority for fiscal year 2023 is hereby approved by the committee and will be submitted to the plenary for deliberation. So, congratulations to the APECO family.
Salamat po, Mr. Thank you.
Thank you po.